See, everything has a flip side also, and I think, and we can't just start adulating one regime and not point out the pitfalls. There are essentially two pitfalls, I think, in the current scenario. I think this government is not engaging enough with Muslims. I think 15% of the population of the country are Muslims, and therefore their number is far too large that you can ignore them. And there is need to engage with them very closely and ensure that they are part of the national mainstream. I won't say anything more on this. The other thing of concern to me is China. I find India extending its olive branch and hand of friendship towards China, which I think is not a thing which should be done so easily, because China not only sits on our northern border, but it also controls, it is also arming our enemies like Pakistan and Bangladesh and even Sri Lanka. It is trying to encircle India from all four sides. So China, India has to be wary of China. Indian manufacturers are today entered into every enclave of the country. Even about 2 years ago, I was unwell and I was admitted to Apollo Hospital and the bed looked very funny. So I asked the doctors, where do you get this bed from? So they said, we imported from China. Not only that, kites, Bhuj handicrafts, pins, everything from China. Everything is brought from China, so what are you going to do? Now, the Chinese want to set up shop in our SEZs here. So very soon, the Chinese will control you. But do you want that? The China also has controls Tibet. And Tibet, 11 rivers in Asia owe their origin to Tibet. 11 rivers in Asia, starting from Brahmaputra to Indus to other rivers in Southeast Asia, all start from Tibet. And therefore, China controls the water resources of Asia. So China is not a country I would want India to engage with, but this government is still not possibly realized it. I'm sure sooner or later they will. These are some of the points I wanted to imagine, and I hope you have learned something out of it. And you shall ask me more questions. Thank you.